Hello students, hope you all are fine. Good. Today we will continue our revision of chapter 2, that is rise and spread of Islam. So today we will discuss on a topic 5 principles or pillars of Islam. Muhammad praised the observance of the 5 principles or pillars of Islam by Muslims. So first one was Shahada. There is only one God or Allah, and Muhammad is the prophet of Allah. Second, Salat. Every Muslim must offer prayers, that is Namaz, 5 times a day. Third one is Sawm. Muslims must observe fast from dawn to dusk in the holy month of Ramzan. Fourth, Zakat. Muslims must give a certain portion of their wealth as alms to help the poor. And last, fifth, that is Hajj. Muslims must go on the pilgrimage or Hajj to Kaaba in Makkah at least once in their lifetime. Now, our next topic is Caliphate and spread of Islam. After the death of Muhammad, the caliphate was established, and the caliphate represented the political leadership of the Muslim. The head of the caliphate was known as caliph or khalifa. The first caliph was Abu Bakr, a close friend of Muhammad. Abu Bakr and his 3 successors are Umar, Usman and Ali. Ruled from 632 AD to 661 AD. After the death of Ali, Muawiyah Umayyad became the caliph, and with him began the reign of the Umayyad caliphate or dynasty. So now our next topic is the Umayyad dynasty. The Umayyad dynasty ruled from 661 AD to 750 AD. Their capital was Damascus in Syria. The Umayyad continued to win new territories and spread Islam in all the directions. They constructed famous buildings such as the Dome of the Rock at Jerusalem and the Umayyad Mosque at Damascus. Now our next topic is the Abbasid dynasty. The Abbasid dynasty overthrew the Umayyads in 750 AD. Under the Abbasids, the caliphate amassed a large, prosperous and powerful empire in the world, and they ruled for about 500 years. The reign of the Abbasids is also termed as the Islamic Golden Age. Muslims made great progress in the field of science, mathematics, literature, art, medicine, architecture and other disciplines. So the political power of that time was good, and it was declining because of the purchase of Turkish slaves by the caliphs to help them to manage their large empire. Gradually, the provincial Turkish slave governors became powerful and independent. They turned the provinces into their kingdoms and then reduced the power of the Abbasid caliphate. Finally, the Abbasid rule ended with the capture of Baghdad by the Mongols in 1258 AD. Now, our next topic is impact of Islam. So, the Abbasid established the House of Wisdom in Baghdad, and it works on a Roman, Indian and other works of literature, science, mathematics, etc. By saving ancient knowledge from extinction, Muslim scholars and scientists have paved the way of scientific progress. Then the literature, the golden Islamic period, the great works have done. That's like a Rubaiyat by Omar Khayyam, Sahmah by Firdausi and many more. Then there is a rise in the number of inventions. The Chinese techniques were developed for making paper and silk weaving. Then modern educational and scientific institutions have their origins. Library and degree granting university are there. Then the contribution of Islamic civilization in the field of mathematics, including algebra and algorithm. Then Islamic added a new dimension to the art of calligraphy, and Muslim cities had advanced sanitization, domestic water systems, and many piped drinking water supplies and toilet also. Muslim developed a beautiful style of architecture, and it is reflected in the impressive mosques and forts. So student, after seeing this video, go through the chapter, just underline the important points and learn it. So thank you and take care.